plane figures. First section is measuring angles. You can check from your book page 1A to 4. Okay, let's start the lesson. Before starting lesson, of course, I want to tell about the angles. As you remember, to form an angle, we need two rays. So let me take two rays from here. So first ray, let's put that one a little longer. To form an angle, I need the second ray with a common endpoint. So the endpoint is here. As you see, arrowhead is that here. It's continue from here to the infinity. So this is the endpoint. I need to put an endpoint here for the second ray. Then, okay, this is our second ray. Now, when we get two ray, so we get an angle. This is called a shape. This shape called an angle. So to measure it, of course, we will use a protractor. But I want to show you why we cannot use this ruler. So first, let's check that one. Why we cannot use the ruler? Okay. I get it. That's okay. Now, as you see here, 3 centimeter. Now, 30 millimeter, this makes 3 centimeter. 10, 20, 30. If I calculate it from here, the distance between two arm of the angle, so it's become 65 millimeter, so 6.5 centimeter. So it's changed. You see, if I close the vertex, it will come 1 centimeter, for example, here. So it's changed. If I calculate it ruler, it depends where I put the ruler, right? So this ruler didn't work. Let's throw it. Okay, now what we will use, it's here. So this is called protractor. To calculate the angles, to measure the angles, we use protractor. As you see, let's make it a little large. That's better, I think you can see the numbers now. As you see, from here is 0, 10, 20, 30, 40. And the other side, again, we have 0, 10, 20, 30, 40. It's very useful if we get two zeros here. Let's check how we use it. Okay, as you see, there's a zero, and this is the zero line, the zero angle. And there's a 90 degrees right angle, and this is the 90 degrees line. This line. So they're intersecting here, this point, yeah. I will take this point and put to the endpoint vertex of the angle. So two endpoints intersect here. We call it vertex of the angle. So I put it there. So let me, as you see, it's not on the line. So it's not on the ray at the moment. So I need to change it. Yeah, now it's zero and this is on the ray. Let's check. Zero, 10 degrees, 20 degrees, 30 degrees, 31, 32, 33, 34, 35. Now this is 35 degrees when I put it here. Let's a little shrink. You see again it's 35. Large at the end, again 35. Very small, so 30, 35. So you see it doesn't matter. It's not depend on how I put it. If I put the correct place, this center of the protractor, if I put it endpoint, so it doesn't depend how it's bigger or smaller protractor. It's all time 35 degrees, as you see here. This is the 35. It doesn't change. So we measure the angles by using this protractor. Don't forget, the center of the protractor must be at the endpoint. Why this is center? If I make it full protractor, as you see, this is the circle. Yeah, and this is the endpoint, the center of the circle. So the endpoint must be at the center of the protractor. But the zero is here now. As you see, this is full. Let's check this one. Does it change? I don't think so, but let's try it, right? Why not? Okay, yes, this zero is here. Zero, 10, 20, 30, again, it's 35. So it didn't change. But I don't need full protractor. Half is enough for us. So it's 35 degrees. We measure it. To measure it, you must. Okay. Let's continue with some measuring some different angle. This is angle A, B, C. As you see, this is point A, point C, and the vertex is point B. So vertex must be at the middle. I can call these angle names, angle A, B, C. So you can say angle C, B, A. It's okay, but I will call it angle A, B, C. So C, B, A, it's okay too. So to calculate it, let's put the center. It's okay. Now zero on the 0 must be that one, okay. Now it's okay, it's 10, 20, 30, 40, 45 degrees. So I can say that measure of an angle ABC, it's equal to 45 degrees. This is the first one. So measure of ABC, it's done. Let's send it. Let's take it here. Sorry. Okay. Let's take another angle. In any angle, angle DEF, it looks like 90 degrees. I hope it's 90 degrees. So, yeah. As you see, 0, 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, 80, 90. So what is the name of this angle? D, look, E is at the center, so be careful here. D, E, F. So measure of D, E, F is equal to 90. So degrees is important here. Also not zero. Ah, degrees, okay. As you see, measure of angle DEF, or you can say measure of angle FED, no problem, but not EDF. FED is okay. DEF, I already wrote it. So measure of angle DEF is equal to 90 degrees. Okay, that's done. Let's send it away again. Oops, go away. Now take another one. Where is it? Oh, here. PQR. So to measure it, look, again, I'm going to put the center of the protractor to the up end point. I did it. Now, okay, zero on the ray. So the other is, oh, 40 degrees. Yeah, this is 40 degrees. 10, 20, 30, 40. Look, zero is here. Zero, 10, 20, 30, 40 degrees. So angle PQR, so here, measure of angle PQR, it's equal to 40 degrees. Oh, sorry, this is wrong because I need to write the degree at the top, that one, yeah. 40 and degrees. So measure of PQR or RQP, it's okay again. But vertex all time must be here at the middle. So measure of PQR, it's equal to 40 degrees. So this done. Let's send the PQR out of the screen. Goodbye, angle PQR. Now let's come to the new angle, and this is the challenging one maybe. The idea is same. As you see, this is look like an obtuse angle. Again, I will take the center of my protractor to the end point, so vertex, I put it. Let's make the row. Yeah, that's better. Now, zero. It doesn't matter which hand. So look, zero is here now. 0, 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, 80, 90. 120 C, so you don't need to count it. So 120. And I can say 21. So 121 degrees. Let's flip it and calculate from here. It will be the same. It doesn't matter how you calculate. Again, now put it on the, come on, come to on this. Then, sorry about it. I cannot put the endpoint zero line. Yeah, that's good. Zero on the line. Endpoint is correct. Again, 121 degrees. So nothing changed. You can put the zero here, or the ray KL, or you can put the zero LM, ray LM. So it doesn't change. The measure of the KLM, angle KLM, equal 121 degrees. Let's write it. Measure of KLM, it's equal to 121 degrees. So it's coming, yeah. Measure of KLM, it's equal to 121 degrees. So as I say, that one. Oh, sorry, not here. Yeah, this angle from here to here, or here to here. So this angle, it doesn't matter, 121 degrees. Let's continue what we have. So now we know some things about measuring angles. Now let's say there is an example. If you see the example, Example 1, measure the angles. So which angles? Let's calculate first A, O, B. Where is the A, O, B here? A, O, B. The idea is same. I will take this protractor. I will put it the zero on the ray. And now it's on the ray. It is. It doesn't matter. I can put it here too, but it's okay. I put there. So 90, 120, 130, 140 degrees. So measure of AOB equal 130 degrees. I forget the symbol of the degrees. You need to put here a small circle for the degree. That's the first one. Thank for AOB. Let's see another one. DOE. So DOE is here. So as you see, notation of the angle, let's go back. So here in your book, we use that one. But there are some books, this notation, the top is a, look like an obtuse angle. So it's a meaning angle. And there's a difference notation. So it doesn't matter. It's again, we call it angle DOE. So I will put this again O, our center. Why did I change it? I don't know. So, okay. Zero must be on the ray. A bit time ago. So, okay, now it's equal 25 degrees. So DOE, it's equal 25 degrees. Let's write it here too. Don't forget the degree symbol this time. Okay. So angle of DOE, it's equal 25 degrees. So what was the first one? Angle AOB, it's equal 130 degrees. So this is the first some examples. So in your book, there are lots of examples. You can solve them at home if you have a protractor. Let's continue. Okay. Two angles. There are two things I want to tell after the measuring angle. So we learn how to calculate the angles by using the protractor. Now, two angles are adjacent if they have a common vertex and are separated by a common ray. So vertex, you know, endpoints, it's here. So there are two angles. First one, let's call for blue is good for you. This angle. First angle is that one. So the vertex is here. So second angle is that one. So the vertex, again, you see the same, the common vertex. And it must be separated by a common ray. So where is the common ray here? Let's draw the common ray. As you see, at the middle, we have here a common ray. So when two angles has a common vertex here, let's put a dot. As you see, here, common vertex, the brown one, and the common ray, the light blue. So we call these two angles adjacent angle. They are like neighbors sitting together in the class. They are close friends. So these are the common vertex. They have common vertex and a common ray. We call them adjacent angles. So this is first thing I want to tell. The second thing is congruent angle. If two angles are congruent, then they have the same measure. If two angles have the same measure, then they are congruent. So to congruent, we need to know two things. If they are congruent, they have same measure. If they have same measure, we call them, they are congruent. So this is the angle congruence postulate. So these two all time works. If they are congruent, they have same measure. By the other way, if they have same measure, they are congruent. Okay, let's continue. Example 2 about identify adjacent angles and congruent angles. So as you remember, adjacent angles have a common vertex. So let's see. First question, name two adjacent angle. I will copy it and paste it here to work on that side. Okay, I want to name two adjacent angle, so I can choose any of them. Let's say that one. This is angle ABF, so I can choose angle ABF and angle BFC. So as you see, F is the common vertex, so FB, ray FB is the common side of the angle, we can say. So the angle AFB and BFC are, what are they? Adjacent. Another one, if you like, that's two angles. So it's a two adjacent angle. Yeah, there are two angles and they are adjacent. We gave the answer. Let's and I'll find another one for you. Okay. Angle EFD and angle DFC. Sorry, it doesn't work. Why it didn't work? I don't know. Ah, that's okay. So angle DFC. So EFD and DFC, they are adjacent angle. They have F is the common vertex here again, and FD, this ray, is the common side. Okay, now we find two of them. I show you two of them. Let's write one of them. Let's write here. What did you say? Angle EFD. So I want to write an angle like a book. Angle EFD. And again, angle, what is the name of the second angle? DFC. DFC. Okay. So I can say that angle EFD and angle DFC are adjacent. Of course, you can say angle AFB, BFC, EFA, AFB are adjacent. These are the correct. It's okay. We can say that they are correct too. Okay, let's clean that one. Oops, sorry, not this here. Okay, I wanted to copy the answer the other side. So the answer of the A is here. This is okay. Now let's see the B. B says, name two congruent angles. So what was the congruent angles? They have same measure. So which one look like has same measure? It can be AFB, AFE, they look like. EFD and BFC, they look like. So to see it, I need the measure. Okay. Okay, AFB is 63 degrees. Keep in your mind, 63 degrees. AF is 90 degrees. Okay. 35 degrees EFD. And BFC, 35 degrees. Okay, we found it. So these two angles, they have 35 degrees. So 35 degrees. And this is 35 degrees. They have common. These two angles have same measure. So we will call them congruent angles. So angle EFD and BFC are